We continue. In this class, I will teach you GPT. Sorry. I already finished the lecture for the GPT. So I will, this week, probably is week 15. So we have 16 and 17, two more weeks to go. So I will teach you GPT later. 那个讲义我准备好了，花了一两个两三个礼拜把它准备好了，所以我会教你 GP 最新的技术 GPT， 所以我教了二十几年，这个讲义我每年都更改一些，像我昨天星期一没睡觉，准备背星期二的课，我昨天睡了2个小时，背今天的课。 不是鼓励你睡都不睡了，因为每个人身体状况不一样，那每个人的方式不一样，所以自己找出自己的方法。有些人习惯工作晚上，有些人习惯工作的正常。但是我的经验是，你还是不要晚上还是要睡觉，比如说，因为有些人睡醒以后，睡醒以后，你知道12点1点再开始工作，哎，我不。 我的经验，因为我跟医生常在一起，你不要这样子哈，这会坏掉。因为人的生理状况就是，人的生理状况真的是，好像11点就忘记了，反正11点就开始休息这样子。那你年轻还好，年轻1-2点。我以前在 CMU 的时候，去的时候，然后到12点，大家都在，我们老板也在啊，继续工作。 然后12点就开始有人回去了，到2点，我老板还在，不敢下，不敢，因为他是菜鸟，不敢走，这他可以还在那边工作。2点多他可以回去，回去我们大就跟着回去，开车就回去。然后一开始，就我早上，大概那个走路去嘛，那时候还没下学的时候，就晚九快9点的时候。 就去实验室工作，哇！老板就在，然后这样几天，哎，我老板怎么都在？晚上不管多晚，他早上都在。然后就老板不会管我那么多了，然后忍不住我就问秘书，老板什么时候开始上班？啊，老板8点就来了，不管多晚就8点就来了。 我记得有一次那个刚 meeting 完，12点 meeting 完，晚上12点 meeting 完了，然后回去，然后在做博士一直在想，然后回去赶快把 Takeo 讲的交代的东西赶快程式把它改完，改完以后就那个就 email 给他说把结果 email 给他说，哎，我先做完了，那时候2点，2点准备睡觉，我做很高兴送给他，然后就去洗澡，准备睡觉，然后。 那个就回来准备关机再看一下，我老板回了，跟我讲哪边有错，哪边有错，哪边有错，我只好赶快再改，改完要4点了，4点要再 email 给他说我改完了，然后就准备要睡觉，然后就躺下来睡觉，然后觉得真的这么。 这么写吗？真的会看吗、啊？就开机再看一下，我老板又回了，又跟我讲剩下哪里要改，我不敢再送给他了，<笑>就算了。然后明天早上8点到再8点又再没有8点了，我都比他晚了，我老板8点上班，我都晚学生晚一点点，大概8点多就走出去，哎，8点他又在那边。 搞不清楚他到底，所以我说不能这样比。哎，有些人的天分就是不用睡觉，有些人不用跟他这样比。但是我赶快就给他了，就赶快8点半9点快9点到，然后赶快再花，我已经写完就再给他，就去的时候给他这样子。 然后他是白天在忙，就没有回我，所以这个每个人状况好不一样，但是自己要规律生活了，就要规律。好，那我们继续。虽然那边很多很奇怪，你看到很多很奇怪的气氛，很特殊的人，都是天才型的。Takeo 是那时候智商全日本第二名，也是在有久了，然后那个博士生到最后跟老板都很好嘛，哈，相依为命嘛，然后就在聊天，他就自己讲出来，他说他是全日本智商第二高的，第二多，第二高不知道多高，我不晓得，他们有那个国小有测，国小国中的测，全日本第二高。然后他说他是在开玩笑，他说应当他是第一高的。他说有一次他很怕狗，因为小时候不知道在走路的时候，有一只狗突然从巷子跑出来，然后吓到了，然后吓到倒下去，撞到石头就晕倒了。醒来的时候在医院，他说如果那一次我没有晕倒，他可能是全日本智商第一名。我们学长说不是啊，你因为撞了以后智商变高，但你是没那么高。OK，遇到很多有18岁大学毕业的那个 Harry 像那个18岁大学，我们遇到18岁大学毕业的，在 CMU 那边遇到很多很特殊的人，他们都很好，他们都帮我们。OK，so back to here。So first, we start talk about best and first. So we have loss function here. 这个就跳过去。哦，对。那 So what's the drawback of the first RCNN? Okay. Because we back to here. So first, here. First is because here, we still use computer vision for the detection. So this is a drawback. So, and the other drawback is here because this is fully connected. So the fixed size. So they use SPP to improve this result. So the two drawback. So faster they improve, they use CNN plus RPN to improve the computer vision method. They use fully convolutional network to improve fully connection. So two parts. So that's a Q&A. Like I train my student, I always tell them all the training for the graduate students, how can you find the problems and how can you solve the problems? And this is the first one, Q&A. The second one is you need to have an individual work ability. You need to have a teamwork ability. 就两个，你要有独立研究能力跟合作的能力，就这两个。那我在那边也是，我们老板就跟我讲，这也是一样，就是 Q&A 跟合作跟独立研究能力，这样的话就可以毕业了，这样子。我们在美国没有 paper 了。我们老师说可以毕业你就毕业了。我是不管是匹兹堡或是 CMU，老师权力很大，我们没有在算 paper 的，只要可以毕业就毕业。所以台湾算 paper 怪怪的。paper 很重要，但是不应当这样子的。回到这边，So here, this is the problems here. Okay, so drawback of fast RCNN is a static search. It's not a network. Okay, and so that will cause you process slow. Because you need to do the computer vision and then do the network, so it's slow. So the solution is a faster RCNN. So they include the region proposal network here. So we'll talk about this one very soon. So before we talk about first RCNN, first of all, I will back to the first RCNN is this original network. So for the classification, you should select this region. So original image here, right? So you need to use computer vision for detect. So we detect the cat and input, for example, input to the XNet and for the classification. So this kind of a classification is that we call index, this one, histogram index. So suppose in their case, they have 1,000 classes. So the total output probability is one. Summation all over the probability is one. And so each class has a probability. So this one, this kind of result is a traditional classification. You can modify this one to be convolutional. The convolutional, the output is heat map difference. So even though right now you think about which one is better for your research, you can do classification based on neural network, or you can use convolution. So in this example for convolution, we have 1,000 classes, is meaning your output will need to have 1,000 heat maps. Which one is better? To me, this one is better. Because for the heat map, this is a distribution like a Gaussian distribution. So you can find if there's a classified to the cat. So that's meaning, I say again, they have 1,000 heat maps. So one heat map is for the cat. So the cat, we can detect the cat here. And they have a distribution, higher distribution. The other heat map is for the dog. If they don't have a dog, they have a human being in that heat map, they almost has no higher probability result. 就如果其他的，因为这里有狗跟猫，那你有1000类，那有些类别表示人，那它 heat map 就几乎没有自然。所以 heat map 有什么好处 ？Heat map can tell you the position, and the probability for entire distribution. So heat map is good. So even though right now people still use heat map, so right now we call attention. 目前你们在看这些 paper 产生 heat map， 最后都变成 attention 的东西，就 importance。 那目前就是在改良这个 importance， 所以你看这两个。 差一点点而已啊，只是这里改成 convolution 啊，那是全连接，这所以这是 called fully convolutional network， 两个几乎一模一样，但结果是不一样，这样子，就这注意一下。那 back to here， so this network they can use if they want to use small network, they use XNet at that time. They can use VGG instead, depend on you. So 这种分类就看你要用什么工具来用. You can use ResNet, because ResNet basically is better than VGG. VGG is better than XNet. So ResNet is better. But still, why people use VGG, not use ResNet sometimes? Because VGG, the structure is simple. ResNet is deep is good, but a little bit complicated compared with VGG, but reason is still simple. So people sometimes you'll find people don't use ResNet 101. No, they will use ResNet 50, or even they use ResNet 34 because they want to modify the ResNet. Okay, continue. This is VGG. It's VGG simple. Right? I like VGG. Like a unit. The same. If we talk about unit here. Unit. Unit, you can use a simple one. You can use VGG. You can use ResNet. The unit. The structure. So unit is basically, you can see three kind of unit. It's original unit. Just talk about original. Two convolution down sampling. Two convolution down sampling. That's original one. You can use VGG, but you should deconvolution. That's a symmetric. 就对称嘛, encoder 跟 decoder 要对称. You can use ResNet. But the problem is, if we use ResNet, how can you do the upsampling? ResNet encoder decoder, right? So original unit, no problems. Oh, sorry, unit. If you use XNet, there's no problems. Oh, sorry, VGG. VGG, no problems. In VGG很单纯啊, 就13个 convolution, 再13个 upsampling 就回来了, 没问题啊。 那你用 ResNet 怎么做？ 你的 unit 架构用 ResNet 怎么做？ 你要想这个问题， paper 有 叫 REST unit， when you Google Scholar you find REST unit， they tell you they use ResNet for the unit。 And they were deconvolution. 这你自己在找了。就 ResNet 有结果很好哦，不好哦 ，ResNet 很好哦。就你做研究要这样去想。再继续。So we just 讲完了。Okay, so the last one is the first term. 前面这个讲义都在帮你复习啦，帮你整理而已啦。 就历史嘛，让你整理这个。 So we talk about faster. So what's the faster? Faster, easy way, I use page 18 tell you. Easy way faster is this one. Convolution, like VGG 16. And then they include one more important, we call region proposal network for object detection. This one. So they detect the bounding box. They input convolution, and that's use simple convolution, and do the region proposal network. So this is a important one is loss function. So important CNN for encoder, they do for the loss function just for the classification, but we want to detect the bounding box. So RPN, they include two small loss. One is for regression for bounding box. The other is a foreground background loss function. So there are two loss, small loss function combined together. This one, again, is a like. The same as here. Two loss function. One is a classification. The other is a bounding box. But for the classification, if it's a region proposal network, we want to do detection. Detection is only foreground class and background class. In that case, only two classes, foreground, background. If the final output here, suppose 80 classes, And then the same, the only difference is here, the output is 80 classes. 不一样只有在这里, 那我们回到这里, so this one, RPN is only two classes. So after you detect the region, so we use RPN instead of computer vision method. So this network. And after you detect the bounding box, others here, the same as first RCNN. So first RCNN is here, the header, they use first RCNN. And there, the stage one here, they use RPN instead of computer vision method. But between both stage, here is a normalization. They use ROI alignment for normalization. And for the mask here, okay, they have a other loss function, mask. It's for segmentation. So faster RCNN or mask RCNN actually is the same one. The only difference is the output here. Output here, this head, right? For the raster, for the region proposed, bounding box. We have a classification, we have bounding box. And this is regression. For the mask segmentation is for each pixel, it's foreground or background. So this one is a binary classification for each pixel. Okay. So this is a segmentation. This is a bounding box. One question. If I want to detect bounding box, I can use this one. Just loop the same, but I don't need this one. Right? If I want to do segmentation, I don't need this one. I only keep this one. But I tell you, for the loss function, your original loss, if you have a plus one constraint, usually the result is better. That's meaning if I want to do the mask, if I use bounding box to be the constraint turn, actually the result is better. So this depends on you. When you do a segmentation, why not include bounding box constraint to be the constraint? So for the training, you have one more loss function is bounding box. For the inference, you delete this one. You don't need this one. So you have better result here. But in the other side, if I want to do the bounding box detection, I have one more loss function, it's a mask. In theory, the result will be better. But why people don't use that one? Most people don't use that one. The problem is the labeling, because bounding box is the labeling easy, just the bounding box. For the mask, it's not easy because you need to do the segment. It's inconvenient. Okay, so that's why actually people do bounding box, they don't use the mask constraint. Actually, it's because they don't have a label. They don't label the mask. So they don't have this result. You don't have a ground truth of the segmentation result. 就是为什么人家有看到 mask, 有用 bounding box, 因为 mask 就可以, 你只要 mask 完就可以找到 bounding box, 那很自动, 就找最左上, 最左上角 跟最右下角, 就有个 bounding box, 所以只要做那个 segmentation, bounding box 就自动出来嘛, 是 labeling 的问题。 所以你做 bounding box 可以加, 做 segmentation 可以做 bounding box 进来。 可是反过来讲，为什么做 bounding box 的人就没有 不把 segmentation 当 constraint 啊，因为 bounding box 画很简单，segment 很难画啊，所以就是你就是没有这个 data，没有这个 ground truth 啊，所以就因为这个，因为没有 ground truth 就不做了，就这样子，是这个原因哦，啊，是我讲的。OK，好，那我们回到这里。So for the faster, actually is this one. We have a CNN here, and you have one more. Second one is a region proposal network for bounding box. And after you have bounding box, you go back to the feature here and crop the feature to here. You have a bounding box, just bounding box, and you go back to feature map here and crop the corresponding feature map to here. And do the normalization. And then do the same here. This one is the same as here. 一样。这个就 faster. 所以这个就 faster. Head. So we have convolutional. And then we have neural network fully connected and do the bounding box to the classification. For the mask, we come here and do the convolution and get a result. Okay, so this for faster RCNN. 再继续。这里哦, I would like to mention here, ROI here is cannot derivative, 这不能微分。这有个小问题会在这里。那有 people 要改成 STN 的方式，这个我就这我们实验室有做了，这是一个，这是 affine transform， 这是 affine transform， 这有改良，我这就不提，那另外一篇 paper， and this is the other method to draw this one， 相同但是不同的画法，我让你看一下是 backbone feature map， and this RPN， so RPN got a bounding box and try to crop the region to here， so normalize the region。And do the classification, do the regression. So this is the other method and the other way to draw the result. 那是我跳过去了。这里要跟你讲什么？是跟你讲说，注意一下。Original for the first RCNN.RPN is individual. This is individual paper for RPN. RPN 本身是一篇 paper. Just got the foreground for the detection. So we input image. We have a convolution extraction encoder. And then we got a bounding box. And this one, we do the extraction. Right? We do the extraction. And suppose we have a region or we do the classification here.So this is for detection, and this is for the classification. But in the initial backbone, all are for the feature extraction. So why not combine together? So you can combine both together. Even though this is for the detection and this is for the classification, but this part is for the encoder extraction. So we can combine to be the same backbone. But only difference is here, have a little bit extraction. 我要讲一下，这个有时候 multitask, 你的 network 是可以 combine 在一起哦。那我刚举的例子，这个你是要解，就 multitask 在真的在做，你看这个 multitask 的东西。你看这里进来以后，理论上你看这个是这一条路是做 classification， 这一条路是做 bounding box。那这里前面这里理论上这两个都 network 嘛，可以 can combine together。But the purpose is different because this is for classification, this is for regression. So in the last one or two layers, you can separate. For example, Suppose you have five layers, right? Five, five layers. And one, the five layers, if you have four, it's four classification, that's okay. Five layers is for bumping bus, it's okay. But for the multi-task, you combine the data. So you cannot have a five layers and the output is two different loss function. That's incorrect. You need to have a, suppose, three layers to be together. The last two layers, one is for classification. The other two is for bounding bus because the purpose difference. So five layers, you can three, first three layer, you can do extraction. The second, the last the two layers is for different purpose. So the same as here. The five layers, the extraction, but layers here has a little bit there, only one or two there for this purpose, and this is for the other purpose. So, 这要注意一下。 The final, I would like to tell you is what's the anchor? Anchor is what's the anchor? That's meaning, how can you detect the region? 你怎么detect 这个 region? 我们讲那个 region, 这 region proposal, proposal 就 detection 嘛, 就 predict, 对不起, proposal 是 prediction, 那 region 就是一个 bounding box, 那 region prediction network, or region proposal network, 那这个怎么来的? So, in the RPN, they use called anchors. But there were two kinds of methods. One method, they use anchors. The other method, they don't use anchors. But here, I explain to you, use the anchors. So what's anchors? Anchors meaning I use this one, easy to say. This one will be easy. So suppose this is a, this one, suppose is a, like a, here, the last one. So suppose right now we have a 7x7x512 feature maps in the last layer. So this one is here. So this is 7x7. And we call grid. Here we call grid. This original one, original is supposed to 512 by 512 resolution. After we do the encoder and become, oh sorry, it's probably 256. 256 by 256, after 5 downsampling, here becomes 7 by 7. If it's 512 by 512, after 5 downsampling, become 14 by 14. But in this case, suppose this is 7 by 7 by 512 feature maps. Okay. And for each one, we call grid. 格子, grid. And for each grid is this one. So this one is grid. Each is grid. So each grid, we put 9 different size of anchor here. 就是每个 grid, 我把它套 9个 anchor 在上面。 那我再举, 9个 anchor 是怎么设计的? 是这里。 So we have three different scale. So different scale is, suppose, the original one. 假设这个原来的一个 piece of one by one. And then 3x3 and 5x5. So I have three kind of scales. So original is 1x1, 3x3, 5x5. And each scale, I have three ratio. It's 1:1, EBE, 1:2, 2:1, this anchor. So I have three scales, and three ratio. Total has 9 anchors. And that's meaning for each anchor here, for each, this, see, so many anchors. So for each anchor, I want to detect whether inside this anchor has a object no object. In each anchor, I want to detect inside the anchor whether there's a object or non-object. So object is foreground, non-object background. So first of all, why I want to do three scales? Because I don't know the images, the object size. So in this, like this example, the dog is probably is 5x5. The 5x5 bigger. The bicycle is 5x5. Oh, sorry, probably dog is 3x3. We got 1x1, 3x3, 5x5 size. So dog probably is a 3x3. Bicycle is 5x5. The small car behind the scene, this one in background, this is 1x1. Okay. And the ratio is 1x1. 1x2 is like the car, the bicycle, 1:2 嘛. 2:1 is people. Stand. When people stand, all the tree, 这种直立的东西, 它可能是 2:1的比例。 它是躺的东西1:2，它是一般其他东西1:1，所以它就用这三种比例来，那不一定对，但是它就说这边配合先用这种方式，所以它有九种 anchor， 是这个原因，可以哈，它希望这九种 anchor 就可以把1000种的物体都把它套到里面，就把涵盖在里面，就这里。So each grid has 9 anchors， 每个 grid 都有九个。 anchor， 所以你们一大堆 anchor 在这里，每一个点哦，每个 grid， 它都套九个东西在里面，这样子，这 anchor。So that's the candidate. Okay. So for the region proposal network, for example, we have this one. 我们假设这个是一个例子啦，哈，这个例子，那这个例子就有一个箭头在这边，会一棵树在这边。那我们来看。 这个 ratio， 那是假设 ratio 是假设这个 anchor 是 3:3 的大小，那你看这个箭头事实上，如果是横的来讲， 2:1，就是这个横的呢， 1:2， 里面没东西啊，so this anchor is deleted，is one is a ratio is this one 2:1， that's correct， this 1x1 is correct， so for this object, they hit two anchors. For example, we have the same scale. This is 3x3, but we have 3 ratio. But in this case, we hit two anchors. 这样子是这个例子，可以啊。所以这就一堆 anchor 在这里。那我们最后会从 anchor 里面。 再去挑，就是不要的就不对的，没有 object 就把它杀掉，有 object 就保留下来，然后最后会把 anchor 用 non-maximum separation 后面讲，再把它合并，像这个就会合并成一跟二就合并成一个，因为 overlap， 这我后面再讲。我这里最主要要跟你让 you know is what's anchor for? Anchor is for the initial bounding box。 For the object, that's called anchor. So after you have an initial anchor, and then based on the initial anchor, we do this one, bounding box. Because we have loss function, we do regression that the anchor size become like, we have a new center, new W and new H. So we'll fit the object. Also, we have the other one we call foreground background score. So we want to based on your ground truth, you want to know this the object inside this anchor is a foreground or background. So the final result for the RPN is that we have a X, Y, W, H, and one more term is a C confidence of background or foreground. So that's for region proposal network. And how can we know this is a object, this object or not object, because we have a labeling. We have a ground truth. So for the RPN, first of all, we need to label this one. So this we label, okay, this is dog. We crop it. They have a bicycle, crop it. We have a car, crop it. So you have the region for the ground truth. You have a foreground object to be ground truth. So based on the ground truth, our loss function, based on the initial anchor position, we can try to do regression to approximate the position. 这样子. So YOLO, all the YOLO use the anchor for the detection. The same. 你现在看到所有的 YOLO 都是用这个方式来做，一模一样哦。 所以都是 anchor base 的。 这样子, 啊, 所以 YOLO 是从 faster 开始延伸, 所以 YOLO 它的 head 都是用别人的方法, YOLO 的, 它是改善这个里面的 network, 但是它的 head 没有改变, 直接用 faster RCNN 来用, 这样子, okay. Now this is some result here. And this confidence, this is a RPN, and this confidence value. But as I said, this result sometimes is not good. So later on, we will use second stage for refinement. 这个红色是 RPN 的结果，蓝色是我们后面再继续做强化的结果，这样子。嗯，这里刚讲了。 时间到了，OK，we take a 10 minutes break and we'll continue talk about this issue.